The tension in Karno was palpable during the last days of February. While international forces have begun to disarm armed groups, progress is slow and the atrocities persist. Meanwhile, around 1,000 people from the Muslim community fleeing to Cameroon have found themselves trapped in the town. They are now living in the Catholic Church compound under the protection of African Union soldiers. This is an explosive situation that degenerates regularly. After a night of clashes, several casualties with bullet wounds were brought to Karno Hospital, where MSF is working.
He was shot twice in the shoulder and a bullet exited through his armpit. He has lost a lot of blood and he's in shock.
MSF decided to send an emergency surgical team from Bangui to cope with the influx of casualties. They referred the most serious cases to the capital and stayed in Karno to continue to treat others.
So we prepared the operating theater and then we operated on two patients. We were able to do it here because the surgery was minor and only required mild anesthesia and routine post-op care. While we were finishing up, four more casualties were brought in. We'd been told that two had minor injuries, so we weren't expecting the two children. One is a little girl who has a gunshot wound in her neck. She is suffering from shock, but it doesn't look serious. And then there's her little sister. Her condition is deteriorating rapidly.
This influx of casualties reflects the violence that is so prevalent here. But despite the tensions, Médecins Sans Frontières is well regarded by all the various communities. The teams assist the displaced at the church while working in other of the town's districts. They also continue MSF's activities at the hospital, where the organization has been providing support since 2010 to the pediatric, TB and HIV units, irrespective of whether their patients are civilians or fighters and the side they are on.